Aloha, and thank you for joining us. Thank you, Eva Lani. That was amazing, and I really appreciate the community involvement and communication around this. As you know, we're going to go do a gong journey. Ka'imi and I are going to play some metal, play some bowls, play some new chimes. This is our newest. So I invite you to, it looks like it's gone. Sorry, technical difficulties. I've had sound come through my computer and mess everything up. So I just wanted to make sure that was off. One more thing, get us back to the control panel. And we're excited about what's going to happen. I'm still hearing it. I hope you're not.
Aloha and welcome, everyone. Okay. Get things a little bit more prepared before we begin the sound.
Not the computer, the Zoom meeting. Somebody was projecting through the. Anyway, it's all good. So, the invitation is to find a relaxing, easy place to be and prepare to be there for a little while, 45 minutes, maybe an hour, not quite sure how long it's going. And then stop and take a few breaths with me and Ka'imi, because after that little fiasco, I need to calm down. So I invite you to breathe down deep into your na'au, your dantian. And you, as you take several of these breaths with us, we invite you to grow roots. Whatever area is closest to the ground, your feet or your back if you're laying down, or whatever is in contact closest to the earth, I invite you to just let the roots grow into Mama Gaia with each breath. Dropping out of your head space. Dropping into your heart space. Separating out of the muggle world for a little while and allowing yourself to receive. Been loving this rain the last few days. A little muggy at times, but it's really, the sound of the stream is back, and it's just so very soothing. So, do we have an intention?
Yes, I'd like to mention, I'm calling this tonight a cosmic sound journey, because we've been talking about our galactic ohana, and this is an opportunity for us to tune into them. We actually had a sound journey once at the end of an audio oasis, where afterwards the person who was playing the gong said that there was a point at which some short ETs came into the room, and he felt and saw them. He connected with them. When he acknowledged them, his gong playing changed. They were transmitting through him a little bit different way of playing the gong. And the wonderful thing was that he told us this afterwards, and there was another woman in the room who has high sense perception, who's psychic, and she confirmed that she had seen them as well. And they had gone over to our kitchen and sat on the top of the cabinets. There's some space above the cabinets because our kitchen has a cathedral ceiling. They sat up there for the whole rest of the gong journey. So who knows what will happen tonight? But anyway, it's an opportunity for us to connect with our own galactic ohana, or anybody we want to call in from that world as we journey with the gong. Okay? Mahalo.
Let's do it.
Mahalo.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
The invitation is to come aware of your breath. Maybe you'll feel it in your belly. Maybe at the tip of your nose. And just become aware of it and how it flows. I make up that there are bits of light and joy in all of our lives. And I invite you to bring one of those back to consciousness with you. One of those bright spots. I went to play the raft drum and a baby gecko was on it. And after he crawled on me for a few minutes, I put him on the root chakra bowl. And he's still cruising around the edge. That's a bright spot for me. We appreciate the time that you spend with us. Both in Audio Oasis and here. So as you progress through the rest of your day and into tomorrow, please drink water. I say it almost every time. That much vibration moves things in your body and helps release toxins and tensions and things that are well suited to being flushed, and water helps. And in addition to your body, I invite you to be careful with your thoughts and your emotions. Allow this time of rebirth after the gong bath To be one where you're careful and loving and kind to yourself. I do believe that kindness to myself is like dropping a stone in a pond and the ripples go forever. And so I invite you to pretend that's true. And treat yourself well.
Mahalo aloha.
Be well.